I take this opportunity to invite the chairman of the Adani Group, Shri Gautam Adani, to address this gathering. Sadasane abhisambodhana cheyyunnathinayi Adani Group chairman Shri Gautam Adani kshanikkunnu.
Honorable Chief Minister of Kerala, Shri Oman Chandiji, Honorable Union Minister of Road Transport, Highways and Shipping, Shri Nitin Gadkari ji, Honorable Speaker, Shri N. Sakthan ji, Honorable Minister of Port, Shri K. Babu, Honorable Member of Parliament for Thiruvananthapuram, Shri Sasi Tharoor ji, Honorable Members of the Councils of Ministers, Honorable Members of the Legislative Assembly, Seniors Official of the State of Kerala, representatives of media, and my dear friends, Namaste. It was this 17th of August that we are here in the beautiful state of Kerala to sign the Vizhinjam International Seaport Project Concession Agreement. At that time, I had promised that together we would make Vizhinjam one of the world's largest mega transshipment ports, a port that would make the people of Kerala, the state of Kerala, and the nation proud. Today, we are here to initiate the execution of this promise, a 25 years old cherished dream of the people of Kerala. Honorable Chief Minister, the personal interest and the support that you and the Honorable Minister of Port, Shri Babu, have provided us has been extraordinary. The help we have received from your Chief Secretary, Principal Secretary, and VISL as the nodal agency for this project, every step of the way has been outstanding. Shri Sasi Tharoor ji, your advice and constant encouragement was crucial as we went through our decision-making process. Honorable Chief Minister, I have no hesitation in saying that our overall engagement with the state of Kerala is a stellar example of how a corporate and state government should work together to make such projects of national importance a reality. I would also like to express my gratitude to the Honorable Union Minister, Shri Nitin Gadkari ji, for his support and approving the VGF that was critical for the feasibility of this project of this scale. Shri Gadkari ji, the way you have accelerated the establishing of the national policy framework that set down how transportation infrastructure needs to be evaluated, planned, financed, and developed, and the way you have encouraged a solid basis for communication with the stakeholders and the public is the need of the hour for India. What you have achieved in a short span of 18 months is a great example of how significant an impact a leader with vision and actual experience can make to our sector. The construction of the Vizhinjam port will be a very complex project. It will see us building one of the most difficult breakwaters ever built in India's maritime history. Given the strategic significance of this project to both the state of Kerala and the Adani Group, we will need a tremendous amount of goodwill from all the political parties as well as the local people to make it a reality. As seen during the bidding process, given the scale of challenge involved in the construction of this port, none other than Adani Group were ready to take this project. However, we bid because we believe in our mission of nation building. We believe in the commitment the Honorable CM made to us on behalf of people of Kerala. And we believe that as the largest port company in the country, we have the responsibility to make this project a success. During my previous trip, I had visited and sought the blessing of the Honorable Leader of Opposition, Sri Achyutanandanji, and was very encouraged by his patriotic words of support. Therefore, irrespective of who is in power at the center or the state, I humbly request their support and support from the people of Kerala to put Kerala's and India's development priorities ahead of everything and help us make the Vizhinjam project a port we can showcase to the world. It is the first phase of Vizhinjam Port that we are commencing today. Over the next decade, we expect the port capacity to have expanded over 3 times, significantly quicker than the period of the concession agreement. Vizhinjam's locational advantage, with its strategic access to Middle East, Suez Canal, the coast of East Africa, Bay of Bengal, and the Strait of Malacca, is unmatched. Situated within 15 nautical miles of the world's primary trade route, carrying over 30% of the world's container traffic, Vizhinjam provides the state of Kerala a unique opportunity to quickly add over 2 million TU of transshipment cargo that otherwise India is losing to other countries. In fact, today, about 28% of India export-import cargo is transshipped in foreign ports like Colombo, Dubai, and Singapore. Because port costs in India are steep for foreign flagged vessels, to enable national programs like Make in India and the government's target to double the exports to $1,900 million by the year 2020, it is necessary that foreign flag vessels are allowed to carry cargo between the various Indian ports. To bring in greater economics of scale for the shipping lines and India more competitive, we have therefore asked for support from Sri Gadkari ji and the Government of India for the relaxation of cabotage law to help ensure that Vizhinjam International Seaport Project is transformational not just for Kerala, but also for the maritime future of India. One thing the Adani Group prides itself on is track record in meticulous planning, resource mobilization, and execution. This has allowed us to complete every one of our projects to date ahead of schedule. However, our initial achievement here beats all our past records. I must congratulate my Adani team for a tremendous achievement. As per Vizhinjam Port Concession Agreement, we had a 270 days to complete the preparation and initiate work. We are ready in just 110 days. Our reconfirmatory surveys and investigation for the critical components are nearly complete, and we are well advanced with the engineering design for all major port structures. The engineering required for the port construction, work like the approach road, installation of way bridges, and site establishment works are already ready, and activities for the breakwater also is commencing. Also, given the criticality of dredging, we have already mobilized our cutter suction dredger with its support vessels and crew to initiate the massive work of dredging the basin and navigational channel. We are starting this from tomorrow. One of the primary reasons this acceleration has been possible is because of the constant help and sense of urgency with which the government of Kerala has moved to address issues that otherwise tend to slow down mobilization and delay clearances. When we talk about ease of doing business, I can emphatically state that it is happening in Kerala. We had set ourselves a very ambitious goal of completing this project in a record of 1,000 days, beginning today. If we continue to get this level of support from the state government and the people of Kerala, I am confident we can beat even this very ambitious timeline. Our experience over the past several years has taught us that development of any port-based ecosystem is directly related to the harmony we are able to establish with the local fishing community. It is their goodwill with which we will have to start the work, and it is with their goodwill that we will be able to operate the port. I will promise that the port will not be a hindrance to their livelihood, and we will add more berthing area to the existing fishing harbor. We will also seek their input to stay associated with other work and measures that will enhance their livelihood in this area. By the time the port commences operations, we will have offered the local youth the skill development and training necessary to take up the job required to operate the port. We will also have created opportunities for the local people to establish their own small businesses, to build a flourishing ecosystem around Vizhinjam to support the port. We have successfully done this many times in our different port locations across India, and we will quickly do the same in Vizhinjam. Also, given the breathtaking beauty of the Vizhinjam shoreline and the prosperity we hope to bring to this region, it is apt that we call our CSR program Thira Samudri, meaning shoreline prosperity. As part of this program, we are committed to spending rupees 35 crores over the next 3 years. Our work will include healthcare, sanitation, water supply, and upgradation of schools, as well as other activities we plan to jointly identify with the local residents. Friends, the last time we were here, we were touched by the sincerity of the reception you gave the Adani team. Vizhinjam, for me, is now about the prestige of the people of Kerala, about the prestige of the people of India, and about the prestige of the Adani Group. Once again, I sincerely request all your support, and I am confident that we will deliver to you a showcase port that will touch the lives of many thousands of people who live in this blessed region. Thank you, and Jai Hind.